Hi guys, this is Heidi with Opticom. So I'm here today and we are talking about the LCDI-35T. So that is a test monitor, right? So our test monitor is 3.5 inches in size. And the whole reason we're talking about this today is because if you're an installer or you are just the guy that happens to be the guy that installs the cameras at whatever facility or site or location that you're at, then you definitely want to have a test monitor. So we're going to run through this with everything that comes in the box and a few of the features and just kind of get you familiar with it, kind of get your brain working and make sure that you have one of these, whether it's one of ours or elsewhere, right? But this is definitely something that you need if you're installing cameras. So here we go. So here's the box, right? So got it here. I'm going to open it up and kind of show you how it comes because it's a whole package that comes in here. So first of all, we've got the manual, right? So this is a really thick manual, okay? So I like this. It's 110 pages. That's a big manual for a test monitor. So this thing can do a lot of stuff. That just gives you a general idea. So we'll put that aside. And then it comes in this cool carry case, right? So you get this. It's got the two hooks on the side here. So you can hook a strap, carry it. You know, I'm sure you can carry it like a purse. I'm sure there's a lot of guys out there that would be super excited about this. That was a lot of sarcasm. So if you go here, lift it up, right? It's got a zipper compartment right around here. So if you need to put anything else in it, and then it actually zips in here. So all the stuff that comes with this is the actual monitor, which we'll open that and look at that in just a minute. And then you've got the straps here that go for the carrying case. You've got the power supply for this. You've got another strap here. So this one actually goes onto the test monitor, right? So you have it around your neck or on your shoulder or wherever. So when you're working on your camera and everything, you've got your test monitor right there. If it slips out of your hand, you catch it, right? And it doesn't drop to the ground, to the floor if you're up on a ladder. So that's really cool. So the test monitor, just if you're not sure why you would want one, this is a monitor you would use when you're actually plugging in cameras and hooking them up to test what you have. So you plug your camera in to see if it's working, if it's got power coming to it, if you need to adjust the varifocal lens in it. You can do that with the monitor right in front of you. If you want to test the cable that you have, test your power. This one does quite a lot. So it'll test IP cameras. So it's got quite an array of things that we'll test. So I'll keep pulling this stuff out here. I think that's it. Okay. So we've got, right, I think this is the multimeter tester here. We've got a small BNC jumper cable here. We've got a power extender here. And we've got, you electricians have got this stuff, all of these electrical components here. So I'm going to stick that right in there. And what we'll do is I'll actually plug this into the little outlet right here. Hang on. So these do not come powered up, so you need to note that. So you need to charge it as soon as you get it. So I'll plug this in. Well, before I plug it in, actually, I'll show you some of the features. So here's the actual monitor, right, without the bubble wrap. So it's got this handle here, right, strap right here, so that you can keep your hand on it when you're using it, right, so it doesn't fall off or whatever. Again, kind of like the same other thing, the safety strap. A lot of the different things I'll show you here where you can see it really well, right? So you've got your power and your BNC in and out over here. And then on the side, we've got, this is where the two straps that I was telling you about that go around your neck, those slide right in there. You've got your IP, oh wait, wrong side, Ethernet port right here. And then you've got a micro SD slot right here. So you can actually record on this. So if you're up there and you're adjusting a camera and you see something crazy going on, right, you can record it and show your friends and put it on YouTube. It works out perfect. A lot of different buttons up here. So here, we'll go through some of those. On the other side over here, we've got some more of the RJ45 connections, okay? So here, we've got your power button. Oh, let me plug it in. So the power button, right, you have to hold it down for a hot minute or two. Well, second, let me get this thing plugged in here. All right, starting up here. Okay, it's loading, right? So let me move my computer a little bit closer because I'm restricted now with this cable I have. You can't really see. Okay. So the camera tester, so it's going in. So, right, so this supports 4K, H.265, H.264, and then it does the analog as well, right? So you can kind of see here the layout of it. It is a touch screen, right? So if I click on IP camera test, right, I just click on that. We can go to, you know, you've got Chrome, you've got the actual testing right here, the network tool. It's got a lot of different apps for different manufacturers, which is really cool, right? So it's kind of, it's very OnViz compliant, open platform where you can plug anybody's camera in to test on this and it should just auto. pick it right up on the IP stuff, right? Obviously the analog doesn't have to config anything. So you kind of go through here and it's got just the different apps. So if we go to Envif right there, right, it's got the device list, which obviously nothing's plugged into it right now, but it's going to list it out. You can add, you can log in and do everything you need. So this is really great. You can set up some of the settings on the camera, right, sitting there at the camera instead of waiting till you get back on the network or at the NVR or whatever you're setting up. So just to give you an idea here, let me X out of this. Yeah, hope I hit the wrong button there. Okay. So, and then you've got the analog setup, right? And then you've got, this has got different apps, and I think it's got apps from different factories as well. The same idea, the rapid video, cable tester, right? So you can test the different cables. You have the RJ45, or if you have just a standard cable tester. And you know what? I didn't show you. It comes with a separate little square with an RJ45 connection. That's the cable tester. And I think when I was going through this earlier, I set it on the side and I didn't bring it over here. It's coming to me now. Thank you. So this is it, right? So you've got this as well. So, and that's the cable tester. Okay, so here. So you can put notes in here. You can do the video player. Again, you can record to this SD. So when you record, you can even play it back on here if you wanted to. So there's a lot of different options. You've got a calculator, a flashlight, a lot of different things. It's basically like having a giant phone in your pocket that you can plug cameras into. So however you want to, you know, go with that. So it's really cool. You can work on your PTZ control. As you see on here, I'll put this down real quick for a minute, and we can go through some of the different specifications. I don't want that to fall. So we've got the 3.5-inch, right, built-in Wi-Fi. So a lot of options is what we're talking about here. You can zoom in, you can zoom out. It's got a power output, right, up to 12-volt, 1 amp for a camera. So if you're testing cameras, you can plug it in right there before you run cable to it or before you necessarily put a 110. Sometimes people will go and they'll run like a 110, 120 right there next to the camera. You can test it right there, all of that before you have everything there, before you do an install. It's got one channel of audio signal output, and then that supports the record and saves the audio as well. The H.265, as I said, it supports the 4K, which is the 8 megapixel, and farther down, obviously. The PTZ, the UTP cable tester, data monitor, network tester, PoE test, right? You want to make sure your PoE is working. And it's got the external power supply and then the battery, right? I showed you that. Rechargeable. So you've got a 3 to 4 hour charge. It's going to give you about 8 hours. Right, so you need to plug this thing in when you get to work in the morning, because at noon you're going to be installing cameras and you're going to be good to go into the night, right? So that's really important. There's a long charge time. You don't have to plug this thing and charge it every single time you go to use it. The touch screen, I showed you the OSD menu, all of that. Pretty standard on the temperature range, right? Negative 10 to 50, I think that's what, 14 to, I don't know, 122 Fahrenheit, I believe. So a lot of different things. It'll support the 1080p, the ping, IP address scan, audio, things like that. I think that's probably it, but that just kind of gives you a quick rundown. It is, again, Envif compliant, right? So quick rundown on this unit and how it's used. And I think that if you don't have one, you should probably have one. If you're installing cameras, like I said, if you're just a plant guy that installs the cameras, like a plant, like a facility plant, not like a plant, like a flower, but a plant guy that installs cameras, then you should have one of these. You know, if you're a distribution, you know, I mean, your installer should have these. So it's definitely something to think about. So again, if you have any questions, give us a call. Our number is 1-800-578-1853. Or you can visit our website at www.opticomtech.com. Again, I am Heidi, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. And thank you so much for joining us.